Hello everyone, welcome back to the new video from Talent Battle. I am Ajinkya. In this video, we will be solving some questions asked by TCS in previous year exam. Focus will be more on time speed distance concept. So let's start with the questions. Before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel for the latest campus updates and to learn various aptitude questions, do subscribe to our channel. Now let's start with the question. Let's check this question. C and D live in the same house. At 10 a.m., they together start traveling towards a T-junction from their house on MG Road with a speed of 20 kmph and 40 kmph respectively. At T-junction on their path, C turns left at the T-junction at 12 p.m. D reaches the T-junction earlier and then turns the right. Both of them continue traveling till 2 p.m. What is the distance between C and D at 2 p.m. from the T-junction? So the question is based on time-speed distance concept, you can say. Now what they have said, C and D live in the same house at same house. So suppose this is their house, okay? At 10 a.m. they together start traveling towards a T-junction. So suppose they are traveling towards a T-junction, suppose this is one T-junction, okay? Then they have given the speed also. C is traveling at a speed of 20 kmph and D is traveling at a speed of 40 kmph. At T-junction on their path, C turns left and at 12 p.m. So they have started at 10 a.m. okay, this is the data which they have given. And C reaches this particular point at 12 p.m. So 12 p.m. means after 2 hours, C is reaching at this particular point. As we know, the speed of C is 20 km per hour. So in 2 hours, C will cover 40 km. So I can say the distance between the house and the distance of this point is 40 km. And then C has taken the left. So as you can check, I will write the journey of C over here. C has started from 10 a.m. C reached to this particular point at 12 p.m. we can say. Then what has happened? He has continued up to 2 p.m. So then he has taken the left direction and on the left he has continued for the next 2 hours. So up to 2 p.m. I can say. So in 2 hours, how much distance C will cover? As we know, the speed of C is 20 km per hour. C will be, if I want to draw like this, this will be 40 km from this point. So C will cover 40 km when he takes left from the T-junction. Now what will happen to the D? D reaches the T-junction earlier and turns the right. So as you can check, both have started at 10 a.m. The distance between their house and this particular point is 40 km. So to cover this particular point, D will require 1 hour only, as speed of D is 40 km per hour, and then he has taken the right direction. So as you can check, I will write about the D's direction over here. D started at 10 a.m. He reached to the T-junction, this particular point, at 11 a.m. because the distance was 40 km and the speed of D is 40 kmph. And then he has taken the right direction and continued the traveling till 2 p.m. So till 2 p.m. means how many hours? As you can check, this will be 3 hours journey for D. In 3 hours, how much distance D will cover? As we can check, the speed of D is 40. In 3 hours, D will cover 120 km onto the right direction. So this particular direction, D will cover 120 km. So as you can check, C has covered 40 km on the left. D has covered 120 km on the right. What is the distance between C and D at 2 p.m. from the T-junction? This is the T-junction. If you calculate the total distance, 40 plus 120, the total distance is going to be 160. So the answer for this question will be 160 km. Let's check this question. A person travels from Pune to Mumbai using cycle at 7.5 kmph. Another person travels the same distance in the train at a speed of 30 kmph and reached 30 minutes earlier. Find the distance. Now again, this question is based on time-speed distance concept. What they have given? the two persons who are traveling from Pune to Mumbai are covering the same distance. So I can say distance traveled by a person who is going on cycle will be equal to distance traveled by a person who is going in a train. Now, what extra data they have given? The time taken by the person who is going in the train reached 30 minutes earlier. Okay, so what I will do, first I will calculate the time taken by the person who is going through a cycle. So suppose if I consider it like T1, okay, the cycle person. So time is equal to distance by speed, as we know. As we don't know the distance, I will consider it like x, and divided by the speed of cycle is 7.5. So this is my first equation. Now what will be the second equation for the person who is traveling in a train? Time taken by the second person is equal to distance, distance is again x, divided by the speed of train, which is 30. So this is the second equation. Now what data I am having? The time taken by the train the train is reaching 30 minutes earlier. So I can say time taken by cycle minus time taken by train is equal to 30 minutes. Right, the difference between the time taken by cycle and the time taken by train is 30 minutes. So I will put just the values. T1 is nothing but x by 7.5. So x divided by 7.5 minus T2 is x by 30. As we are dealing in kilometer per hour, we need to convert these minutes into hours. So this will be 30 minutes divided by 60. Just we have put the value of T1 and T2. Now we can calculate this quickly. This will become 1 by 2. Okay, I will write the calculation onto this side. So 30x minus 7.5x, which is 22.5x, divided by 30 into 7.5 is equal to 1 by 2. Now just do the calculation quickly. I will take x over here and all the numbers on the right side. So 30 into 7.5 divided by 22.5 into 2. So as you can check, 2 into 1, 2 into 15. This will be 7.5 into 1 and 7.5 into 3 is 22.5. Simple calculation. And 15 by 3 is nothing but 5. What was the x? X was the distance which we have considered, and ultimately we need to find out the distance only. So the value of x is 5 km. So the answer will be A, 5 km. So we have just used the simple equation, the time taken by the cycle minus time taken by the train is equal to 30 minutes. In time, we have substituted distance divided by speed, and then you will get the answer as 5 km. Plane C travels at ground speed of 100 km/h more than another plane D on a certain flight. The faster plane requires 2 hours 45 minutes and the slower plane requires 3 hours 24 minutes to cover the certain distance. What is the total distance of the flight? So what they have said, they have given us two planes, plane C and plane D, and ultimately we need to calculate the distance. So for that, first we need to know what is the speed of plane C and plane D. So I will write plane C over here and plane D over here. What data they have given about speed? C travels at a ground speed of 100 km/h more than another plane D. So what I will do, I will consider the speed of plane C at C km per hour. So what will be the speed of plane D? At speed of C is 100 km more than the plane D. So I can say plane D speed will be, okay, so I will just write speed over here, so it will be easy for you to understand. Speed of plane D is equal to C minus 100 km/h. Now, what data they have given? Faster plane requires 2 hours 45 minutes and slower plane requires 3 hours 24 minutes. So time taken by C is equal to, I can say, distance divided by speed. So time they have given 2 hours 45 minutes, which we need to convert into hours. So I will just write the conversion over here. How we can convert 2 hours 45 minutes completely into hours? 2 hours and 45 minutes will be converted as 45 divided by 60. So 15 into 3 and 15 into 4. This is a mixed fraction. So 4 into 2 is 8. 8 plus 3, 11. the timing is 11 by 4 hours. So time taken by C, I will write over here, which is 11 by 4, is equal to distance, I will take it as x, divided by the speed of C. I have only considered like C only. So 11 by 4 is equal to x by C. This is my first equation. Now what is the timing of D? D has taken 3 hours 24 minutes. So I will just do the conversion over here. 3 hours 24 minutes. So 3 hours will be like this. 24 by 60. That I need to convert. So 12 into 2, 12 into 5, 5 into 3, 15. 15 plus 2, 17. So 17 by 5 is the time taken by D. So I will just write over here. Time taken by D is equal to distance, which is x, which I have considered, and the speed of D, as we know, it is c minus 100. And time taken by D we have already calculated over here. 5 into 3, 15. 15 plus 2, 17 by 5. So 17 by 5 is equal to x upon c minus 100. Now what we can do, we are having two equations right now. Suppose if I equate everything for x, so what will be this equation? This equation will be C into 11 by 4, and this equation will be C minus 100 into 17 divided by 5. If I equate both the equations for x, x is equal to this, x is equal to this, so I can equate these two equations. Now just try to do the calculations. I will clear this part of the screen so it will be easy for you to understand. Till then you can try the calculations. So if I multiply 5 on the left side, it will be 5c into 11, means 55c, is equal to 4 into 17 is 68. 68 into c is nothing but 68c, minus 4 into 17 is 68 into 100, minus 6800. So c will be 55, I will take on the right side, it will become 13c. 6800 I will take on the left side, so it will become positive 1600. So the value of c is nothing but 6800 divided by 13. So now I am having the value of c, which is 6800 divided by 13. What they have asked? They have asked us what is the total distance of the flight. Total distance we have considered as x. So now just you need to put the value in this particular equation. Okay, I will write on this side. Just check. Now, the equation which I was having, 11 by 4 is equal to x by c, this particular equation, and the value of c which I now have is 6800 divided by 13. So take everything on the left side, x will be 11 into 6800 divided by 4 into 13. Now if you calculate this, this will be 4 into 17, so 1700. 11 into 1700 divided by 13, so this will be x is equal to 18700 divided by 13. So try to check what can be the answer. 13 into 1, then 57 means again 4, 5 will be the remainder, 50 means 3. This will be around 1438 point something if you do the perfect calculation. So the answer, as you can check, the near answer to 1438 is 1440. So the answer for this question is B, 1440. The question is very easy. What we have done, we have calculated the time for both the planes, plane C and plane D, and from that we equated the distance over here, if you check, and from that we tried to calculate the value of speed, and then we put that value of speed in this particular equation. So if you again check the question from start, it will be very easy for you to understand this question. So the answer is B, 1440 kilometers. If you like this video, click on the like button. For any doubts, suggestions or feedback, please comment on this video and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned to various placement updates. Press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.